Hey guys, welcome to Focus Counter Violence, a video on movement and motion. And you may be wondering why, with all the videos of techniques and cool kicks and all that stuff, why dedicate just one video to movement and motion? Well, it's the natural physics of things during any violent encounter that there's always going to be movement. To hit somebody, you've got to move a part of your body, your whole body, to hit that person. They have to do the same to you. So they have to move towards you to hit you. This is where Bruce Lee got his concept for intercepting, that on the moment that they came in, he would hit them. Also, if you were to get hit, you would move. Okay? So the very physics of conflict, the very physics of violence says there's going to be motion involved. Now, if you haven't seen our principal video on what counterviolence is, starting with what is violence, what does it mean, what does it look like, how does it act, how does it behave, then take a look at that video. And in that video, it explains that violence behaves a certain way. To know your enemy, to train against violence, to counter violence, you need to have certain things. And we have what's called the focus counterviolence algorithm. Within that algorithm is aliveness, adaptability, and aggressiveness. The aliveness characteristic of that algorithm is motion, resistance, and emotion. Motion being the most important thing needed in a fight. So there's several reasons why motion is important. We're going to call those principles. The first principle of motion is to identify threat levels. Okay? So I need to identify primary threats, secondary threats. All right? So we're going to get started by identifying these primary threats in motion in regarding how they would happen in a street fight. Hang in there. So in training, anytime you train for anything in this world of martial arts, combatives, or counterviolence, there's only two types of way to train: simulation and developmental. So what we're going to do is we're going to isolate the ability to identify threat levels in a simulated manner. Okay? Remember, this isn't a video about techniques. This is the video about the value and principles of motion. Okay, so if I could borrow one of you guys. So what we're going to do now is we're going to step back. We're going to show you that any conflict that happens is normally prepackaged. Okay, so I'm going to step out. So in other words, I've come to this situation, this conflict, and I've had a bad day. Divorced the wife, lost the job, whatever country song you want to play. He was the trigger that set this explosive off. Okay? This is normally how conflicts turn violent. So I'm already emotionally or psychologically displaced. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to move. Ready? And, hey man, what's the problem? So he's going to originally start to move immediately. Okay? So,
take a step back.
So what we're going to do is we're going to cover the CAP method. So what you see is that's how people engage themselves. Hey, what's the problem? What's going on? So what I want to do is give you guys the CAP method. First things first, create space. Okay? So first things he's going to do, he's going to come up, he's got a problem with me.
What's up, dude?
Hey, man. Hey, I'm sorry. Hey. So the first thing I'm doing is moving around, creating space. Okay? Creating space gives me the ability to ascertain how serious is this guy. Is he really wanting to cause me bodily harm, or maybe he's just a little PO'd on the day? Okay, so as we progress for this, I want to forewarn you that there will be some vulgarity because that's a part of violence. So you need to be desensitized to that. So if you have some kids, you want to send them out of the room, now would be the time. Okay, so now I'm going to be the bad guy. He's going to do the C, create space. Okay, while he creates space, he's going to move back up. The posture he's going to take isn't of a fighting stance. Okay, so in these areas of fighting, what you normally see this on a security camera, someone's phone. You'll normally see it when there's a conflict, okay? So during that conflict, time out. You want him, is he in the picture, is that it? Oh, I see. Yeah. So whenever I'm done with you guys just kind of out to the side. So I'll tap you on the chest or something. So let's do that again from, I'll tell you what, I'm going to... Okay, I'm just going to do it all over again. Okay. So we're going to start from the preemptive stage, right? Before the fight starts. Conflict. How did it happen? Right? So someone who's emotionally or psychologically displaced, maybe they had a bad day at work, their wife divorced them, fender bender, what have you. Okay? They've already come prepackaged with enough dynamite to explode. You just happen to be that trigger. Okay? So what I need to do is use space to recognize how serious this guy is in terms of causing me bodily harm. Okay? So first thing in the cap system, create space. So he's going to come over, he's going to play the bad guy, and I'm going to create space.
What's up, dude?
Nothing, man. Relax. Relax, man. Hey.
Relax.
So I'm just going to move around. Very good. Thanks. I'm just going to move around and create space. You notice my structure wasn't this. An era of video, cell phone, and so forth, people can always see. So legally, I'm backing up. I put one hand on the chest, and I put one hand out. Okay? And I moved. While I move, I'm doing the same as I would as a driver. I have a rear view or side mirrors. I'm looking over my shoulder. I'm circling. Okay? So just fair warning, from this point forward, there will be vulgarity. This is a part of violence and conflict. So if we say some vulgar words or use profanity, it is contextually relevant to the realm of violence. It's something we need to be desensitized to. Remember, these things are just as important as any kick or punch that you train this over and over again. Okay? So let's do that again. So if you're going to see, what I'm going to do is I'm going to create space. All right? This time I'll be the bad guy. So come on in. Mike? So Mike's just standing there and I'm going to walk up. Hey, man. What's your problem, dude?
No problem, bro.
Man, no, you got a problem, man. You got a problem.
I got no problem with you, bro.
So, right away, you see Mike checking his six. He's backing up. Now, the problem starts in violence is where people are good citizens. Generally are good citizens. So, when you're confronted with somebody, and Mike, can I borrow you? And what happens is in that, when people are stuck here and he's barking in my face, asking me what my problem is, I'm over here thinking, should I hit him? When do I hit him? Has he demonstrated enough verbal assault to me that gives me the right to hit him? All this stuff is running through my mind. So, and as a good citizen, we're taught what? Don't hit somebody because they call you a name. So I need to move, okay? Thanks, Mike. So keep in mind that the focus is a good citizen model. And so the best thing that you can do instead of sitting there barking with one another is to move. Now let me give you the way not to do it. So Mike's going to get in my face and I'm going to tough guy this out. Mike?
What's up, bro?
Man, what's up with you, man?
What? Up, bro?
Yeah, get it, man. Go.
Yeah, why
go.
Don't you go first?
Okay, so there you go. That's what happens when you're in a fight. People are barking, they're toughing. I can't see the guy coming to hit me from behind because I'm too impressed with my own ego to prove how tough I am to diminish this conflict. Okay? Now, we've got to create space. We've got what not to do. We know how the conflict started, and I'm just the trigger. Now what we're going to do is we're going to apologize. Okay? So, Mike's going to come in, and I'm not, while I create space, I'm going to apologize, whether it's my fault or not. Remember the legality. So if there's a video, someone with a cell phone, or anything like that on scene, and there always is, then you'll be able to legally justify your emotions. Time out. Come on. Mike's going to come up. Again, I'm going to use my emotion to create space. I'm going to back away, check in my six, and then I'm going to apologize. Hey, man.
What's up, Joe?
Hey, man. Nothing. Everything okay? Dude, hey, sorry, man. What's the problem? Hey, I'm sorry. Are you okay?
No.
We're going to call somebody? You all right? Okay. So what we're seeing there is I'm verbally expressing that I don't want to be in this conflict. Whether I was wrong or not, I apologize. Everybody heard me say it, right? Because the realities of violence is police station and hospital. Those are the two places you go in violence. Where you go, well, that's up to you. But if I have to go to court, if I have to hire an attorney, that's made clear. Okay? If I'm like this moving around, it's showing that I'm threatening. And for the good citizen, hey, just trying to ascertain the threat level is very important. So thirdly, what I'm going to do is I'm going to set parameters. Okay? I'm going to set parameters. I'm going to say, hey, I'm going to create space and apologize, but I'm not going to apologize kind of, let me say this way, I'm not going to apologize like I'm a bitch. right? And I'm going to reaffirm my stance to protect myself by creating parameters. That's the P, create parameters. Mike, one more time, please.
What's up, bro?
What's up, man? Huh? Hey, easy. No, I'm sorry. I didn't know she was with you. Hey, back up. Hey, back the fuck up. Back up, man. So, I did those three things. Right? So there's a lot of people who like to preemptively strike. I don't have a problem with that, provided I'm in a position whereby I can't move. And if anybody puts you in a reasonable apprehension of a battery or puts you in a place you can't move, you're legally justified to take action. Okay? But for the good citizen, what if I've got my kids with me? Okay? What if my wife is with me? So we'll cover that in the next section. But I just want to keep that in the back of your head, that all those things matter. Right, when you're dealing with how that fight even started, that conflict. Can I resolve this conflict? Absolutely. We'll play that for you in just a few minutes. But let's go ahead and drill this, shall we? Okay. So now you guys are going to go back and you're going to drill this.
What the fuck, man?
Hey, bro.
Why are you talking to me like that, bro?
Hey, say that.
Huh?
I don't have an issue, bro.
Yeah, you're going to have an issue.
No, say that.
Good, switch.
Watch it, man.
No, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to bump into you, bro.
Yeah, you did.
I don't want no trouble. I don't want no trouble, bro.
Yeah, you do.
No. Go to switch.
Okay.
Is that your girl, bro?
Nah, it's not
my head. Shit, it's over here, bro.
All right, just try it. Hey, stay back.
Just let me take your horse.
Stay back.
Okay, good. We're going to... Ready?
Nope.
Son of a bitch. So this time, do the money thing. Huh?
Can I shoot for a dollar?
Yeah, hey, man. Yeah, give me some. Huh? Ready?
Yeah.
Okay. So, now what we're going to do, the other part of that is recognizing secondary threats. So, now we're recognizing secondary threats through our movement. I'm not just not backing up. I'm moving and looking around. So by the second or third turn, if something hasn't popped off yet, I'm pretty fortunate, okay? But it would be foolish of me just to stand there waiting, hoping, and thinking. Movement gives me that ability to recognize the threat by using the cap system, his severity of how deep it is in terms of my bodily harm, and then recognizing secondary threat levels. Okay, let's play this out for a second.
Hey, bro, I need some money.
What's up, man? I got no money. Hey, back up, dude. Hey, back up. Hey. Hey, back up, both of you, back up. Okay, so right away my movement gave me peripheral that he was coming into play too. I don't know either one of these guys. If I don't know them, they've got no business coming at me like that. Okay, so before we end this section, I want to briefly talk about negating that threat, conflict resolution, okay? So in this particular scenario, this simulation, I've got a problem. And if Mike and I were to get nose to nose, that problem's gonna escalate regardless of my intentions, simply because he's staying in front of my face. Mike's gonna move, and I'm gonna show you how a scenario like this could turn into something very harmless. Okay? Mike, I'm gonna be the bad guy, okay? All right. So I've had a bad day. Things aren't going good. Mike and I just bump. Hey, man, watch where you're going, man.
I'm sorry.
You better be sorry. Hey, man.
I'm sorry, brother.
Hey.
I don't want no trouble, bro.
You're lucky you don't want no trouble. You know what? You don't want any part of me today. All right. So there's one of those situations. Okay, so you see how movement helps you right before the fight even takes off. You can see how it can de-escalate. You're in charge of that through your motion. What you'll find is when you're standing still, your heart starts to race. So do I have my kids with me? Is my wife with me? Do I hit this guy? And if I hit him and engage in him, do they know to follow me? Do they know? Do they have a plan? We don't know. So movement, keeping those people behind you, having those considerations anytime there's conflict is a good thing. Movement should be your best preemptive strike you have. It will help you ascertain the threat level of the first person coming at you or the second person coming at you, it will give you the ability to see what was once behind you. It has so many variables. So let's move on to our second principle. And this is the best principle of all. If you don't want to be hit, don't be there, right? This is common sense, but yet it's very rarely practiced in the martial arts. What you normally see is people stuck in one position, or they're doing this motion in one position. Now, if you were to hit me, I would move, and then you'd have to move to hit me, yes? So when you see people doing focus mitts, and the guy with the mitt is doing more work than the other person, and the guy's not moving while he's hitting, he's actually developing a bad habit. You have to move to hit somebody if you've already hit them, okay? So you just can't assume someone's going to stand still. No one's going to stand still. I wouldn't, nor would you, if you got hit. Impact kinesiology would take over, and you would go into the direction and distance to which you were hit. Okay, so if you don't want to get hit, don't be there. Move. So what we're going to do is we're going to go through some basic drills of movement, footwork, and body work, ways to move the body. Okay, so the first thing we're going to do is like a magnet drill. We're going to have two people mirror each other around in a circle. Okay, they're going to keep their posture here, and they're going to move laterally, and then back and forth. There's eight ways the body can move. It can move forward and backwards. Everybody's pretty good at that. It can also move left, right, up, down, circle left, and circle right. So a combination of all these motions and movements give you a great ability to get out of the way of being hit. All right? Hang in there. Let's play with it. So now you'll go up there, and now you step over the same. All right, so what we're going to do is we're going to do this lateral drill. This is a circular drill, teaching us how to circular, but I got to stand lateral. Like I said, everybody's great forward and backwards, but they stink laterally. So real quick, Dominic and I are going to square up like this. Square up, please. And now when I start to move, he's going to move. I'm not going to tell him which way I'm going to move. He's just going to respond. Okay, Mike, come on in here. And go. Mike, you drive the drill. So Mike's going to determine who goes where. He's going to do the switches. He's the driver. He's the rider of the drill. Good. All right. And stop. So now they're going to get in the left lead. Both in the left lead. And now they're going to go that way, then that way. And go. Straight back, straight forward, nice and smooth, slow. A little more space, please. Good, back, now circle. Circle. Left lead, go. Back, 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 back. Forward. Back. Circle. 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 And break. Thanks, guys. So what you see here, guys, is you see that this footwork gives you an incredible ability just to move. They're not letting the other guy get too close to them. Okay? Hang in there. We're going to move right along. Okay? Good. Okay. Now for a more refined variation of that drill, I'm going to use the weapons. The weapons really bring out a certain thing in the body that you just can't get from jumping rope, right? That's a great footwork drill, right? But in terms of rhythm, I want movement. So what you'll see in the weapons, martial arts, or these things, or other classes when it comes to stances and feet work, or triangles and shapes of geometry on the floor. I like to bypass all of that. I think that's kind of a waste of time. What happens in fighting is when people apply techniques, they learn these techniques, and they learn these techniques against an agreeable partner in their dojo or in their school, or they're doing something that looks cool at the summer barbecue. But when the fight happens, when they're put in the boil and they're confronted with violence, right? They're thrown, they're moving. Now they're trying to put the movement on top of their techniques that they've learned instead of learning the movement first. This is why most martial arts and real fights fall apart, because they're not associated with doing movement and techniques at the same time, because they've learned their techniques, a basket load of techniques, and it looks really cool, But they didn't learn the movement first. The idea is when you learn to move and then apply your techniques, you're a person who can move and hit. And that's what Bruce Lee called one of the most dangerous men you'll ever meet, is someone who can move and hit. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use these weapons as a catalyst for the body's mechanics and how it moves in relationship with me. So instead of just moving in basic ways, I'm gonna have Dominic come in and I'm gonna move, make him move with a stick. And I'm gonna feed him in a way that's somewhat agreeable. I'm not trying to get him, I'm trying to get him to move. Okay, let's start with a stick. So with that stick, you can see he's got to move a lot further and stay out to the outside of that stick. Now I'm going to switch weapons and use the knife. Now he can get a little bit closer. I'm asking more of him to stay as close as he can without getting cut. Okay? As you've seen from those two examples, what we have is an ability to make the body move using a tool that you wouldn't see in MMA or kickboxing. It really gets the body to be responsive. Okay? All right, hang in there. So what we're going to do now is we're going to highlight what I call the Ali Tyson movement. Ali is famous for getting his head back. Tyson is famous for getting his head under. But this is going to be combined with the footwork, right? So I'm going to do it, and I'm going to have Dominic place the stick on my shoulder and just show you a way to get this newcomer in the door moving like a boxer, moving like a good fighter, without having to follow tapes on the floor of triangles and geometry. Okay, so remember, up to this point, we haven't done one technique. We've just been moving around, getting out of the way of the punch, all right? So to work that skill, with the developmental skill, Dominic's gonna hold that on my shoulder. He's gonna stand in one place. For your new student, you're just gonna go up, touch, 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 touch. Now he's gonna come at me. I'm gonna go backwards. One, two, three, four, five. We'll go backwards now. One, two, three, four, five, six. Okay? Much of this is you start to teach new students, or you start to do it yourself. Even if you've been a banger, you'll find that these are coordinating exercises that may have been at one time difficult. But the more you put them together, the better off you'll be. All right? Hang in there. Okay. So what we're going to do now is we're going to do what I call the Ali Tyson. And again, like I said before, Ali went back, Tyson went under. This is just generic terms for getting out of the way of the punch. There's only so many places you can go. You can't go into the punch, right? So I want students to get used to moving and getting out of the way of the punch at the same time. This starts to build what we call perceptual speed, your ability to see the punch coming, okay? Now, when I want to fill that gap, it's easier. It's not done where I say to the guy, I punch and you do all these things while I patiently wait. So when we add our techniques to this movement, you will see rapid growth out of your students in no time at all, okay, as well as your own performance. All right, so Mike and Dominic are going to come in. One person's going to drive the drill, and the other person's just going to get out of the way of the punches. That's it, getting out of the way, whether they're ducking underneath or whether they're going back. They're getting out of the way of the punches. They're circling. They're going up. They're going down. They're going back, forward, side. They're using all the ways they can move while getting out of the punches. So that when it is time to apply those techniques of countermeasures, counterviolence, whatever tool you want to put in at that time, it's going to come at twice the speed with twice the effectiveness. Okay, let's play. Good. Now, Dom, you go. See how they take their time. Look at them just measuring up. Boom, boom. They're not sparring here. They're just exchanging. This is iron sharpening iron. This is a developmental drill. No sparring allowed. Okay, time out. 1 second. Okay, now one person is throwing punches. You're going to have one guy know how to throw punches. The other guy who's moving isn't using any, but he's seeing openings. He's recognizing times to strike. If, again, remember from the very first conflict we had, had I just started face to face, then it's going to be who's faster and who's... Okay, chances are he's not going to weigh the same as you. All the variables are against you. Remember, violence isn't something you do with someone. Violence is something that's done to you. Okay, you go back and you look at our principal video, you will see the definition of violence and how it's obtrusive. It's intrusive into your life. It's not fair. It's asymmetrical. It's high velocity, an active attacker, definitive pressure. Movement is your safest, best option. This time I'm going to have them turn it up just a little bit. Okay, you've seen their punches were good. They were crisp. They were intended. If the guy didn't move, he would have got hit. I'm going to have them turn it up just to about second gear. That was about first gear. Let's go about second gear, maybe third. Okay, guys? So about 3 or 4 punches. Any other guy go about 3 or 4 punches. I don't want them sparring for the specific reason is I don't want two people who weigh differently and different intentions to sit here and get into this kickboxing match. That's not the idea of counterviolence, martial arts, or any other self-defense. It's the idea of sport to exchange punches. I don't want them exchanging punches. I want them to see the punches and get out of the way so we can use the best risk versus reward ratio to combat that punch. Okay, hope you understand. Here we go. Let's go. Turn it just a hair. More motion, more motion. There you go. Boom, bam, there you go. Boom, boom, boom. Good. Good. Stop there, and we'll go up there and transition right into that shot from up deep. Go. Hands up. Good. Good movement. Good movement. Check your six. Always check your six. Look around. Circle, circle. You guys notice they're not just going back and forward. They're circling. They're moving. They're looking behind them. They're checking their six. If you don't want to be hit, don't be there. Move. Good. All right. Break. Okay. So what we're going to do now, we're going to hit the ground. Just because there's not movement, because we're so used to using footwork as a stand-up thing, we're going to show you how footwork or movement on the ground is just as valuable. Hang in there. Okay, so encountering violence, it isn't always just stand-up. Sometimes I've been in a fight where I tripped on the curb. Okay, boom, you fall back, you're on your back now. Does that mean you stop moving? Well, if you're a competitive jiu-jitsu person, you generally kind of move, but you move in a very small area. And violence... Jiu-jitsu is usually done with one person laying and one person standing, trying to get a boot party on this guy's head, more than one person. So we need to start by learning how to move on the ground. We're going to use the traditional shrimp method from jiu-jitsu, but we're going to go from our back to our elbow to our hand. Got that, Dom? From our back to our elbow to our hand. So as soon as Dominic hits the ground, I'm going to just pressure drill him. So when I move, he goes, move, elbow, elbow. Come up on your elbow, boom. Then I'm gonna circle on him. Now he's on his hands. So, the closer I get, the more he goes back. I back up, he gets up. Goes back down. So, shoulder, do your shoulder. Shoulder, elbow, elbow, hand. See, now he's ready to get up, okay? But he's gotta get used to moving. He's gotta get used to moving. Come on. Good. Okay? Very good. Right there. Okay, so what we're going to do now is I want to put these two first principles together. The first principle was recognizing and assessing threats, your threat level. So is this guy really out to kill me, or is he just having a bad day? Either way, my family and everybody's safer if I move. My mind will stop moving. Because when you're standing still, your mind's overwhelmed with options and anticipation. So we're going to put these two together. The preliminary, recognizing and assessing your threat levels, and actually getting out of the way of the hit. So what my guys are going to do is they're going to come in here, they're going to start the problem, but they're going to continue. The guy's going to swing at the other guy, he's going to get out of the way, the other guy's going to arbitrarily just fall. Then he has to move on his back. No techniques on the part of the receiver of the drill. This is all motion for right now. Just these two first principles, let's fuse them together. Okay, hang in there. Okay, so we're going to start with the conflict. They're going to, like I said, they're going to traverse through the whole thing. Nice and slow in first gear. Okay? Remember, this is iron sharpens iron. We're developing a skill set. We're developing attributes. Becoming desensitized to vulgarity and getting as close as we can to the violence that's out there. If this line is violence, I need to be training right here. Okay? That doesn't mean fast and hard. That means quality. We have to do our best to always infuse gross motor stress with fine motor skill. All right, here we go.
Sorry, bro.
Huh?
I'm sorry.
Are you?
Yeah.
Yeah?
Get back. Establish parameters. There you go. Now he moves. He's getting out of the way. He's throwing punches. Boom. Again, keep the pressure on him. He goes down. Now move. Good. Get back over here. Over here. Good. Gets back up. Now the other guy's going to throw the punches. One, two, three. He falls. Boom. Now he's moving. Shrimp. Boom. Get up. And break. Good. As you can see, guys, it doesn't seem like a lot. But when you're used to training in a stationary position without checking your six, without moving around, you're always putting yourself in a vulnerable position. The minute you allow yourself to be here. Now, let me restate something here. Mike's a former law enforcement officer. So the only time I should be in a position whereby, so I used 20 years in security. Now, if I had a problem with someone in the club, I would walk them up to them and confront them face to face because they had information I need to ascertain the situation. It's the only time I would be here with somebody. I wouldn't be here if there's a conflict. The minute he's got a problem, go.
What's up?
Nothing, man. Nothing, dude. What's your problem? Right now, I can act from that position. The only time I should be let someone stay face to face with me is if A, I've got nowhere to move, and apparently I've got a lot of places to move. And if you find yourself, well, where there's no security cameras, there's no other person there, there's nowhere to move, and you're in a corner where you can't move, you should probably check your behavior patterns, right? Because 90% of the time there's going to be that place that you can move. So if you can move, please do. Don't get caught up in this barking. Unless you're in law enforcement and security business where you have to ascertain information, where you're being aggressive with somebody, then, well, you should be able to move. All right? Hang in there. Whenever you're ready. Okay. So here we are now. We've done the moving. Now I want to add another element, and that is, well, our loved ones. Right? Because if we're a good citizen, chances are violence doesn't happen. We're by ourselves walking out of the gym all fired up, ready to go. Maybe we're out to the movies with our loved ones or something, and it happens. So training together, you know, is a good thing. It increases your chance of survival. All right, so I want to give you an example. So when I move, I need my partner, the person I'm with, to stay on my back. So if I do make a motion, she's going to be right there. So that person who I'm with is with me. I move, they move. And can I borrow you for a second? Okay. So, when I begin to move, I get conflict. She's going to go ahead and stay on my back. Oh, so when I move, she's always going to be aware of where I'm at. She's going to move with me. So I always know that no matter where I'm at, she's there. Okay? So we're going to use this. Thanks, Ann. We're going to use this drill, and I'm going to have Ed with her husband actually do this drill, and I'm going to play the bad guy. All right? Hang in there. Okay, here we go. They're going to be a couple. Ann, why don't you get on his side first? And I'm going to walk up and I'm going to have a problem with Ed because he bumped into me. And, well, I just don't like that. But the key point here is to focus on Ann and how she moves in concert with her husband. Okay. Hey, man.
Hey.
What's your problem, dude?
No problem. Take it easy.
No, you got a problem, all right. Hands up. Good. Good movement. Good movement. Check your six. Always check your six. Look around. Circle, circle. You guys notice they're not just going back and forward. They're circling. They're moving. They're looking behind them. They're checking their six. If you don't want to be hit, don't be there. Move. Good. All right. Break.